In his early years, they called him the voice. And what a voice it was.
Sometimes I
As time passed, the nickname changed. Frankie, Old Blue Eyes, he lasted long enough to be called the chairman of the board. You no longer had to be young or old to appreciate the voice.
I've got the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
I thought that you'd want what I want. Sorry, my dear.
His career spanned 60 years, more than 2,000 recordings, 50 movies, and 4 marriages. There was Nancy Barbato, the mother of his 3 children, Ava Gardner, Mia Farrow, and Barbara Marx. The man who loved to be loved was not always likable, but he could sing.
My name is Francis Albert.
He was the only son of a fireman and a midwife in Hoboken, New Jersey. Sinatra was just a skinny kid when he got his break on the Major Bowes Radio Amateur Hour.
We have now the Hoboken 4.
Who speaks for the group?
I will. I'm Frank. We're looking for jobs. How about it?
In 1939, he was signed to sing with the Harry James Orchestra and toured the country for $75 a week.
It's the last.
By 1942, he commanded $7,500 a week. Sinatra was smooth, a crooner, and he made young girls scream.
Kiss me once.
The first time it happened, a publicity agent paid some girls to make a fuss. But after that, Sinatra didn't need help.
People will say we're in love.
Sinatra sat out the Second World War with an eardrum punctured at birth. He did his bit singing for war bond drives.
I'd like to be there, boy, and spread some joy when they take old Berlin.
He was at the top, singing and dancing in a series of films with Gene Kelly.
What a dish, what a dream, what a dame. And she lives alone.
But by the early 50s, Sinatra's career was on the beach. His marriage to Ava Gardner was breaking up. His voice failed. He was broke, hard to work with, harder to live with. Sinatra nearly begged to play the part of Maggio in From Here to Eternity.
And if they put you in a hole, don't yell. Don't make a sound. You'll still be yelling when they come to take you out.
Sinatra said he was Maggio, the scrapper, and by winning the Oscar for Best Supporting Actor, he scrapped his way back. A run of hits followed, movies like The Man with the Golden Arm and Pal Joey.
The only thing about you that appeals to me is your M-U-N-Y, money.
These were his playboy years, the Rat Pack years, with Sammy Davis, Peter Lawford, and Dean Martin. He also palled around with some big names in the mafia, Carlo Gambino and Jimmy the Weasel Fratiano. And in those years, the late 50s and early 60s, he made his best recordings.
Come fly with me, we'll fly away.
This was the Frank Sinatra to remember. He sang it like he had lived it.
So set him up, Joe. I got a little story you ought to know.
He was so overpowering of musical personality, intuition, candor. Anyone who wished to convey emotions and feelings through popular music turned to his recordings to learn how.
And now, the end is near, and so I face the final curtain.
Frank Sinatra became an American icon, a man whose life mirrored the rough and independent image of the country that adored him.
The record shows I took the blow and did it.
Ryan Rooney, ABC News, Hollywood.
The next Starline door.
okay? That's good.
You're going to have breath when you're sitting in the back, right? Unless we do it outside.
No, I know. I'm going to film it.
Yes, my name is Anita Gravine, and the last name is spelled G-R-A-V as in Victor, I-N-E.
And how do you feel when you heard Frank Sinatra die?
Well, I was absolutely devastated. I knew that it was coming. I think most of us knew that it was coming, but it's hard to put into words what the death of a... I mean, legend is too mild a word in describing Frank Sinatra. It's hard to put into words how... the impact it had on me personally.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a singer.
And has he had any influence on
you? Oh, absolutely. I mean, every singer, even those who never heard him, have been influenced by Frank Sinatra. But I'm gratified that I was alive to have him as a teacher, because he was the greatest interpretive singer of this or any other generation. There's no question about it.
You grew up listening to
music? Yes, I did, and I grew up in a family of musicians. My brother was a studio musician for years, so I grew up listening to Frank Sinatra. He was an icon in our family, and in most Italian-American families, Frank Sinatra was, you know, someone to be revered. But he was revered for his musicianship, which was impeccable.
Do you think anyone will ever be able to compare?
No. No. I mean, it's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. Bing Crosby said something wonderful about Frank Sinatra. He said, a singer like Frank Sinatra comes along once in a lifetime, but why did he have to come along in mine? And I think that says it all. We loved him, we revered him. He meant a great deal to American culture. He was the voice of the Second World War and all of those people who stayed with him for years. He was revered and loved and treasured, and he's an American and world treasure because he's famous all over the world. You're quite.
Okay, what are your guys' names, first of all?
Tyler Cash.
How do you spell
them? T-Y-L-E-R-C-A-S-H.
Okay.
Travis Putnam, T-R-A-V-I-S-P-U-T-N-A-M.
Okay, and what did you guys think when you heard Frank Sinatra die?
I was kind of shocked, and I just think, like, his life has been a great contribution to this century as far as music goes, and he reached out to several generations and had an outstanding voice that pretty much no one could duplicate and had to really set a name for himself.
Yeah, he really did have a unique sound quality when he sang, and I know he'd been in a few movies, and I respected that as a performer in both areas.
It's not one of my main listening categories, like the big band era type. I don't want to call it lounge music, but it's when I do hear it, I do respect it.
Yeah, you gotta respect it.
How did your parents feel when he died?
My dad was shocked. He's a big fan, and like when he grew up, it's what his dad listened to. So a lot of my dad listens to a lot of Frank Sinatra too.
Do you think it's more?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think it sort of started as, you know, with back in the 40s and when he started to get in movies and whatnot. And but yeah, I think their parents passed it on to the next generation. You know, he's been around forever, so like 82 years. And long-standing career, so.
Thank you, guys. Okay. Sorry, can you say your name again?
Patricia McDonald.
Okay. So I'll let McDonald go.
Right.
And how did you feel when you heard the Frank Sinatra?
I was sad. It kind of had a feeling this was going to happen soon, but I was sad. I was really, I felt something. I felt sad.
How do you feel about his influence on America?
Very profound. He was one of a kind, and I think he had a major influence. I mean, you see people like Harry Conniff now, is that his name? And that's what comes to mind. But I think that he had a major impact, but can't be duplicated. And did I grow up listening to music? Yeah, my father was a jazz musician. So, and I was a disc jockey myself. He was a Dixieland jazz. He played like Woody Allen type Dixie, you know, Flatfoot, New Orleans. In fact, he didn't like Frank because he thought Frankie was kind of on the mob side of things. But I loved him. I thought he was very romantic, and he was great to listen to when after a bad breakup, you know, like Only the Lonely, The Wee Small Hours of the Morning, that end of the bar voice, as they call it. One of a kind. And I'm going to miss him. Okay.
Sinatra's platinum copy. I think this is the last two, I think, on the shelf that I saw today.
Really?
It's running out fast.
And what's your name?
Jake.
And can you spell it?
Jake, J-A-K-E.
And your last name?
Davila. D-A-V-I-L-A.
Great, thanks. And what did you feel when you turned on the TV this morning?
Well, I thought, when I turned on the TV, I saw his face and they were using the past tense. And I said, was. He must have died, I said to myself. And I was surprised, you know. Nobody knew that he died. They said that he died 2 o'clock this morning.
How did you feel?
Well, I thought we lost the best singer that we ever had.
And how long have you been a Frank Sinatra fan?
Oh, ever since I was still single. I was still in the Philippines. I immigrated here way back in 1978. This is my 20th year in the States. And I was still single in the Philippines, and we used to sing his song. He's been there twice, I think, or 3 times, I don't know. And in all of those concerts, we have attended all those concerts.
And was he very popular?
Oh, yes, yes. Very, very.
And your children, do you have children?
Yes.
Do they listen to
him? They know him very well. They sing his song.
And do you feel that it kind of helped you understand America, listening to all the songs?
Well, you know, we understand America because the Philippines, you know, is a former colony of the United States. We were brought up just like any American, you know.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Well, I think we lost the best singer in the world. He's the best, really.
What kind of influence do you think he had on the music?
Music, as far as music is concerned, I think, well, the teenagers, probably he didn't join the pop music, you know. But I think everybody loves him, you know. There's no doubt about it.
And what did you think of him as a man?
As a man? I have no comment. As far as I'm concerned, he's the best singer.
Thank you so much.
That's
I
okay.
I really appreciate it. It'll be on at 6:30 tonight.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, and what's your name?
Martin Stevens.
How do you spell that?
S-T-E-V-E-N-S.
Martin, is your first name?
Yes.
Okay.
If you could speak up a little bit, it's some noise here.
Oh, if you could speak up because of the noise.
I'll try.
Okay. Don't worry about it. And how did you feel this morning?
Well, I felt very sad about Sinatra dying. When I was a kid, I saw him at the Paramount Theater in New York. We all cut school to go and see him. And very fond memories of Frank. I took my son one time to see him about 10 years ago. My son wanted to go to see the Mets play, and I said I had tickets for Sinatra, and I said, you can always see the Mets, but you can't always see Sinatra. Okay?
What sort of influence did he have on American music?
He was American popular music, he was. He influenced the whole range of singers today. He was a master at phrasing and about, his musicality was tremendous. His emotion was tremendous.
And you mentioned taking your son. Do you think that he has a kind of multi-generational appeal?
Yes, he did definitely have a multi-generational appeal. I know that on the QEW radio station, Sinatra Saturday is a popular program with the young people as well as old people. It's very multi-generational.
What's your favorite song?
Oh, Fly Me to the Moon. He did many. Never Smile Again. Depends on what era you're talking about. I've followed him since I was a kid. When he was a kid, I'm almost as old as he was.
And why would those be your favorite songs?
Oh, just had personal meaning of one sort or another, you know.
Do you think that he, more than others, these songs have more personal meaning for people? Or?
Well, I think many people of many generations could relate to that particular song, you know. Sad songs, happy songs, swingy songs. He was a man of all generations, a singer. It's very sad price then. Okay?
I bet it wasn't that when you first went to see him.
No. The Paramount, we used to go to Paramount to see him, and it was, I think it was 55 cents during the day, and had a motion picture and a stage show, and he was singing then with Tommy Dorsey, and there were millions screaming kids in the audience, and first show was about 2 o'clock, I think, and then what we would do is we'd all get online for the movie at 9 o'clock in the morning, 8:30 in the morning, cutting school, you say, we'd sit and watch this movie from the first row with your head up like this. You couldn't even see it. Finally waiting for Frank, you know. It's really remarkable.
What was it like when he finally came on?
Mayhem. Like the Beatles. Same thing.
And was he as good live as he was?
Oh, he was. I've seen him many times live at various stages in his life. He always projected, and he got the audience involved amazingly. You know, we saw him at Radio City a couple of years ago with Sammy Davis, and people were screaming out for the audience, Frankie, we love you. You know, he really had it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
George, call 194. George Tanitas, 194.
Excuse me, please. Excuse me, gentlemen. Excuse me, let the lady through. Excuse me. Yes.
One question. Are you married to Frank?
No question.
Mia, are you married?
Mia,
you married?
Jilly, are there any marriage plans at all?
I don't think so. I don't know anything about that.
Just stop you for a second and get you to turn around. Right this way. Right this way. Earlier, Mr. Sinatra said that he was not married.
I didn't know. I wasn't even here.
You didn't ask him at all?
No.
The subject never came up?
I don't ask those questions.
Jilly,
really
you're a close friend of Frank's. You would know. Can you let us in?
As far as I know, they're not married. That's all I can tell you. I don't know.
They're a happy couple?
Married. As far as I know, nobody said anything to me.
Are there any plans?
I don't know anything about that.
Would you describe them as a happy couple?
Everybody's happy on board. Why not? I'd like to be out there myself.
Jilly, are they staying on board tonight, Joe?
They went to bed. I'm telling you, Frank just went to bed. I'm not kidding.
I'm not coming ashore tomorrow.
Whose gear is that? Can you tell us?
I don't know.
Excuse me.
Jilly, just for a moment, is Mia and Frank married?
Yes, I were. I don't even know.
You've been on the boat.
I just got here today.
Can you tell us what they look like? What's going on?
What they look like? Yeah. I like to have something like that also. I ain't kidding you. I don't know.
Any talk of marriage?
No, they weren't talking about anything. Believe me. We just had some nice Chinese food and that's it.
Are they coming ashore?
No, they're on the boat. Actually, I'm telling you the truth. They want them.
How long are they going to be here, do you know?
2 days, probably.
When are they going to come ashore? Can you tell us that?
I don't think they're going to come ashore. I doubt it.
You doubt that?
Yeah.
Will they be docking in New York?
No.
Well, why are they here?
I just took a rest. I want to come down and take a rest. Eat some good Chinese food. Out of chilies. What else?
Where did you go for those 10 minutes when you sped off here?
Where do we go?
Where? Yeah, you
dad. Make a phone call.
Smile,
that's all.
She couldn't make it to the boat.
What am I smiling?
She couldn't call from the boat?
No.
Bueno, quería preguntarle qué opinión puede darnos con referencia a la muerte de Frank Sinatra.
Bueno, con relación a la muerte de Frank Sinatra, la voz a nosotros nos ha dejado un poco impactados porque honestamente conocimos a Frank Sinatra de toda la vida. Es uno de los ídolos que tiene conocido el mundo y a fin de cuentas choca mucho. Una cosa que choca mucho, una cosa que duele mucho, pero bueno, es la vida.
Es una pérdida muy grande para el mundo de la música.
Mira, para los cantantes.
Es una pérdida muy grande. Lo sentimos de veras porque aquí en Cuba se conocía mucho la obra de Frank Sinatra.
Muchas gracias.
Realmente pues deja una huella muy profunda en la música a nivel mundial. A mí me tocó apreciarlo en algún lugar donde junto con Sammy Davis y Liza Minnelli, y creo que pierde la música un gran artista, un extraordinario actor también. Realmente lo vamos a extrañar mucho.
¿De qué país es usted, por favor?
México.
De México.
De Los Mochis, Sinaloa.
De México. ¿Y a dónde usted está de visita actualmente aquí?
Acabamos de llegar. Teníamos muchos deseos de estar aquí en este gran país y lo queremos mucho también. Son hermanos y lo vamos a conocer como deseábamos.
Muchas gracias. Hablando un poco sobre la muerte de Frank Sinatra, a ver si nos pudiera decir qué importancia tiene para usted la muerte de él y, no sé, cuáles eran las canciones que más le gustaban.
Sí. Me emociona mucho de estar aquí en Cuba aprendiendo esta noticia, porque es la isla del canto, de todo, del encanto también. Y Frank Sinatra, yo soy belga. Y Franca, hay muchos italianos en Bélgica que han sufrido mucho de la migración y todo. Y para mí, Frank Sinatra, el triunfo de alguien que vino de nada y que cantó y que ha imponido su voz al mundo entero. Que tiene sus defectos y sus cualidades, pero es una personalidad muy importante. Y yo pienso que vamos a estar en duelo de esta voz y que yo conozco desde mi infancia y que me acompaña siempre. Pero Strangers in the Night. Fui muy lindo.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Could you please give us your opinion? How did you find out, or when did you find out about Frank Sinatra?
This morning I see the television here in Havana, and I was very sad. I have a special memory about Frank Sinatra because he was a performer in Amsterdam in a concert building, and I make pictures of him before he was performing, and the manager gave me 2 tickets, and I go with my wife there, and we sit in the first row. And it was a beautiful evening. It was the first time in Holland in the concert building in Amsterdam, and never forget of my life. And after the show, I was private with him in the special room to take pictures for my biggest newspaper in the Netherlands. I was very sad to see this morning. Yeah, special memory about this man. Yeah, because you never forget of your life if you this man in history in voices, you know, and in melody and music. Yeah. And he was in Amsterdam. And, if you see this, this is special. Yeah.
Are you here on business here in Havana?
Yeah, I was from a leading newspaper in Holland to make a report about Havana. And did it 2 years ago. More involved with the tourists.
Ya está grabando. Ah, bueno.
A ver si vos le podías hacer algún comentario sobre la muerte de Frank Sinatra, que nos puede decir.
No, sobre la muerte yo me enteré ahora, la lamento, porque ahora no era muy fanático, pero me gustaba mucho su voz. De aquí decían la voz, exactamente.
¿Dónde aquí? ¿Cómo piensa que se siente el resto de la gente, los compatriotas suyos? ¿Qué opiniones
ha oído? Bueno, todo el que está enterado lo siente. La muerte de Sinatra, de cualquier actor de esos famosos, uno siente la, porque es admirador de él.
¿Y usted trabaja dónde?
Yo trabajo en servicio especial de auto.
¿En qué localizado?
Aquí, me presto servicio a la cadena de hotel Gran Caribe.
¿Usted sabe si Frank Sinatra alguna vez ha estado aquí en Cuba?
Yo tengo entendido, sí, inclusive estuvo en el Hotel Nacional exactamente, en los años 50 más o menos.
¿Y te parece que va a ser una pérdida, vamos a decir?
Una gran pérdida, ¿no? Una gran pérdida.
Muchas gracias.
What can you tell us, can you give us an opinion about Frank Sinatra's death?
I think that we are going to miss him a lot. He was a very important singer. He was the voice. Especially I like his song My Way, Thunder from the Night.
And do you think a lot of people here in, where is it that you work, do a lot of people know him here? And
yeah, I'm sure. They like him. And they know him a lot.
Would you say it's mostly people of a different generation, or mostly do even some of the younger people, have they heard of him?
I think everybody knows him. Not matter of generation or age, everybody knows.
Which place do you work at, and has Frank Sinatra ever stayed here?
I work in the luxury restaurant Aguiar. We have every night we listen to his song My Way. Our pianist play every night this song.
Do people like it when they play it? How does the public react?
I think unconsciously they think in the grounded voice is Frank Sinatra.
Thank you very much.
No, you're welcome.
Yo le estoy comentando que se murió anoche. ¿Qué es lo que usted sabe de él?
Bueno, siento pena por él porque es un artista de mucha fama norteamericano, de la década del 30 y pico, 40 y pico. Cultivó varios géneros, ¿no? Una música popular americana de esa década. Y bueno, aquí en Cuba se ha oído mucha música de él. No muy popular así como otras agrupaciones musicales, pero bueno, se ha oído.
¿Usted sabe que él estuvo aquí en Cuba en algún tiempo?
He oído algo decir que estuvo aquí de visita aquí en Cuba. Pero bueno, no se publicó mucha, no se divulgó mucha visita aquí en La Habana.
Muchas gracias. Ay, chiquitito, no, no sea.
gustaba la música, no me gustaba, qué sé yo, no sé.
No, sí me gustaba.
No, pero, espérese.
Ahora. Sí, sí me gustaba la música.
¿Y qué canciones? ¿Se acuerda los nombres de algunas canciones?
Ese es el problema, que no me acuerdo de ninguna canción.
¿Y el tipo de música, por lo menos?
El tipo de música, el baile.
¿Y usted cree que eso va a ser una pérdida? No sé cómo piensa que la...
Sí, pienso que sí. Además, hay muchas personas que sí le gustaba mucho la música de Frank Sinatra y gustaba bailar con él.
¿Se escuchaba más o menos aquí en Cuba, creo que?
Sí, con Oiga y en películas y todo. Se
y han puesto programas.
Y se han puesto programas.
Muchas gracias.